Hello everyone, this is SystemCollapse, yet again playing Sky Factory 3. I don't know what episode number this is, so yeah. I got a couple more to upload and I just haven't got to it yet. Haven't done much. Haven't done anything, actually. It's probably only about a half an hour since I recorded the last episode, but I realized I had enough to do some stuff and not a half an hour, well, maybe 45 minutes. All I did was build two more capacitor banks, so no, three more. There's one actually in behind, touching the actual conduit. Doesn't actually need a wire, figured that out, so yeah. I can hold 4 million now, not a big deal, but I did that. And that tier 5 crafter that I got, I just hooked it up here. I'm auto-compressing it because I want to get to the beneath. So to get to the beneath, you need this stuff here. So I already have this. I already made quadruple compressed. This thing is insane. This thing lags my game. It's so crazy. Where is it? There you go. And just like that, look at that. Look how choppy that is. I let that run for about 30 minutes and it gave me 5 quadruple compressed. So I'm good to go. But I want to get to this dimension. It's the, what was the one in the last game? The Underdark or whatever the heck it was called. The Deep Dark. There you go. And this is the replacement for it. It's called Beneath. It's actually supposed to be said in the most metal voice you have. So, the Beneath! You know what I mean? Something like that. Something to that effect, anyway. I moved my solar panel just over here. Not much, just over a little bit. Because I'm going to be building something right here. Something colossal. It's going to be amazing. Yeah, I only jumped into this episode right away because I ran some quick numbers and I think I'm right. I don't know if I am, but I think I can get done what I want to get done right away. So we're gonna try. We're gonna try right now, actually. So let's take a look here. What I want to build right away is the Colossal Chest. And I want to jump straight. You can build it out of wood. You can build it out of copper. That would be horrible in this pack. Iron would be easy. Or gold. And each one has more slots for chests. You know what I mean? No, you probably don't know what I mean. Each one, like in the wood chest, if you build, you can build these. These are multi-blocks. So I don't know what the minimum is. I think it's a 3x3 though. If you build it 3x3, and yeah, each block of that multi-block counts as 27 chests. And I know that increases each one you go up. I can't do the diamond, but I'm pretty sure I can manage a gold, and I'm going to do a 7x7, so should give me a massive amount of space. So I'm going to get right to it. I got this. Question is, do I have enough wood right now? I think I do. So I'm going to go through close to 900 gold, I think, today, which is amazing because you get too much gold anyway. So this is actually going to be the easiest one for most people to build if they're sieving. Yeah, I get tons of gold and, I think I needed to do about, I'm going to start off and come back and build more because I don't want to build too much. So you need to build a ton of these chest walls. And when you see this thing built, if you haven't seen it yet, it's actually utterly hilarious. So hilarious and good at the same time. So let's do that. I need a, oops, not one of those. Boop. And it was just this, wasn't it? No, totally wrong. What are you doing? I need an interface. So that was cobblestone. Why do I always get cobblestone? And stone. It's this texture pack. I'm going to blame the texture pack. Because I don't want to admit that I'm a derp. So I'll explain the blocks once I get a bunch of them. Where's the other one? Also chest core, the core. I need a core, so chest wall, I already got. And just an iron ingot. Couldn't be much cheaper. It's actually amazing how cheap these really are. I mean, you don't have to build them as big as I am. A 3x3 one would still give you massive amounts of space. I'm going to build a giant one because I'm going to use it in a different way. Some of you might have already seen these places. You might have not, but this is cool. 6, 7. I would use a wand, but I don't think wands like this. Let's try it. Yeah, see? No, that's the assembler. The wand gonna let me do it? Okay, that's a glitch. That is definitely a glitch. Okay. Well, I think I just got screwed out of gold. Did it actually use the blocks? So I had 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I don't think it actually used the blocks. No, it did. It did. Okay, well. I will report this to Dark Osto, because that's a definite bug. Well, we learned something new here. Do not build this out of gold, and then use a wand on it, or it'll downgrade them to iron, and you'll get screwed out of blocks. Hopefully, I still have enough gold. If I don't, well, I can always make a cut and go do some sieving. So, I'm going to have to do this all manual. So, that's 4, 5, 6, 7. And this is going to take a lot of blocks. This pack is an amazing pack, but my goodness, there's a lot of little bugs. Nothing against Dark Osto, I mean, when you take this many mods from made by this many different people, it's amazing that the packs work, a pack like this works at all. I'm always amazed when people take packs like this and get them up and running, because so much can go wrong, and it does. I mean, it does go wrong, but they managed to get it working in the end, and he's been doing page after page of bug fixes. I've been hanging out in his channel, and I know how diligent the guy is. He doesn't want to leave it. He's stressed out because everyone's giving him a hard time about it, but he's just one guy doing this pack. This isn't a guy, you know, a person with a team of people working on a pack. It's one guy and some mod devs that are not really, they're working on their own mods that they have added to the pack. So we're gonna need a bunch more of these. I'm not sure how many though, and I don't want to overdo it. So let's do it this way. This and this, and each one of these recipes gives you two walls. So if you're trying to calculate it, just count how many blocks you need and cut it in half. I need a, oh, it's a good thing I got that one extra stone as a stepping stone. There we go. And we'll put that, where is it? There we go. Up here. That is what, 5 high? So that's 7. Hardest part is this is going to be the ceiling, but we'll deal with that when we get there. Definitely going to need more. Should have mapped this a little harder. I know watching me build this is probably not that entertaining, but needs to be done. So I'm going to actually break this one for a second, because I actually need to put a different block there. I need to put my interface there. There we go. And boom. Oh, boom. Interface. And we're going to need more. I might have enough. I'm hoping I have enough. I really do. Boop. And I'm going to be really cutting it close, I think. I don't want to make all of them. Let's just do this. I am going to need at least that. I'm going to be close. I might be short. We'll see here. We will see. If so, cut's not a big deal. Is that right? 7. So the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it should be 6. Count it 3 times just to make sure. What's that saying? Measure twice, cut once. Something like that. Riveting. Riveting video right here. It's going to be worth it when it's done, though. Can I get that there? I did it, boys. I did it. Yeah, I'm a big boy now. There we go. And I'm almost definitely not going to have enough gold. Oh, frustrating. But it's okay. It's okay, because I can get gold pretty easy. Hopefully, I still have Ooh, some gravel broken down. Just to speed that up. Well, I'm gonna use it all, everything that I have, get as much of it done. And basically, you build them when you're building this multi-block, it's basically a hollow cube. A hollow cube of these walls. You don't need the interface. I'm gonna use the interface because I'm gonna hook something up to it. That's if you want to hook pipes up to it, be able to transfer things in. But you do need one of these cores. So I'm gonna put my core there. It's good to remember where the core is too. Because once you have items in this, if you break that core, all your items fly over the place. So it's good to keep track of that. And this is going to use, I'm just going to do what I have left and then make sure I don't have any more gold. I thought I had enough. I truly mapped that wrong. Well, you live, you learn. There you go. And I'll have enough for the outside walls. I'm not going to have for the roof. Which sucks, but it is what it is. Oh, it's going to be close to. That's the horrible thing. So what is that? 5 by 5. So I need 25 for that. 3, 4, 5. Oh, it's so close. So I need 25 and I have 13. So what I'm going to do is do a real quick cut. And hopefully I got gravel. That'll only take like 3 minutes. I'm going to do this. I'm gonna go and I'm going to sieve that gravel. I'm gonna smelt it in my thing. What's it called? My smelter. And I'll come back and I'll finish off the top of this. So yeah, I'll be right back and in a second, I guess to you, it'll be about 10 minutes for me. Anyway, I'll be right back. Okay, and I'm back. And I went and I sieved that stuff. Then I sieved another stack of compressed cobblestone. Only took about 5 minutes. Took longer to smelt it. Then I came upstairs and one more time, I counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have an extra layer. I did have enough blocks. Oh well, I'll need the gold and the resources anyway, but yeah, I didn't need to do it all. I had no reason to make the cut. Wouldn't be right if I didn't derp in a video, right? So there's that. But I did end up making more walls, so now I have extra gold walls for no apparent reason. I wish I counted a little better. So I said that little saying there, you know, measure twice, cut once. Yeah, well, I guess I should have measured 3 times. Oh well, you live, you learn. Anyway, we'll be finished here in just a sec. And then we can move on to the second part of it. First part of this is really cool. Second part of this is, well, amazing. Just amazing. So, I want to get to it. And once I'm done doing this, I'm going to sleep so I can get rid of that rain. And the darkness. Because I fear the darkness. No, it's not that I fear the darkness. Actually, mobs, I don't know if they can spawn on these blocks or not. Let's go. Oh, no. Let's do this first. So I got 49 now. No! I guess I'm going down anyway. There we go. There's one way to get down. This back. I guess we can climb back up using some wood. And you can build this multi-block up to a 16 by 16 by 16. I think it has to be even. I'm not positive. Don't quote me on that. But you can build it that big. But I hear that it can start lagging out your game if you do build it that big. So user beware. I can't click right. There we go. That. And I have something. Oh, maybe it's this. Maybe nothing could touch it. We'll see. So this is good, right? Got a thing there. I have a core. Got that. Didn't miss anything back here. I'll just take out the core and put it in again. Or maybe have to hit it again. Gotta be a trick to this. There we go. And look at this hilarity. Let's break that. Look at the size of that chest. Just look at that thing. And the hilarious thing is, watch the top. It actually opens and closes. That thing is awesome. Okay. So that's done. That is done. Thank goodness. I guess I don't need this anymore. And I'm stuck with gold walls because, you know, when I get rich enough, I'll probably switch that to diamond anyway. But that is a ways off. I put my those resources down there. And let's get rid of the wood. There we go. I got 18 diamonds from saving. That's not bad. There we go. Is that all my diamonds? No, I thought I had more. Okay, so let's get on to the next part of this. Oh yeah, let's sleep first. Let's sleep. I want to get on to making my refined storage next. So that is the plan. That is the plan, and we're gonna get right to it. So my refined storage is gonna be, I guess I need a controller. Oh, helps if it has two L's. Controller, and let's look for the right one here. Not there. It's not there. Oh, it's here. Is that it? No. Is that it? No. Nope. Why can't I find it? There she is. So I need quartz enriched iron, a diamond, a machine casing. Let's work on that first. I do have quartz enriched iron. Here, quartz enriched iron. I think that's a drop from the sieve, isn't it? I guess I got it all from loot bags. That doesn't sound right. I guess I got it all from loot bags. Either way, you can make it as well. Couldn't have got that much from loot bags, would I? I did open a bunch of those uncommons at one point. I believe I did that on video. I think I've opened like 100 of those so far, if not more. How would you make it normally? Because I might have to make more, so not right at this point now. So it's just 3 iron and a quartz either way. And that makes 4, so that's a really easy recipe. Quartz enriched iron. I don't need that much, but let's go back to the controller. So the housing is just that. Let's make one of those real quick. I'm gonna have to do some smelting here in a second too, so. Because you have to smelt some really odd things with this. So that, then we need a diamond. Gonna grab a stack of diamonds. I don't need a stack, but I'm gonna need a couple, and I am gonna need a couple gold. And where's my silicon? No, I have it here somewhere. Might be over here. Silicon? 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 I can make more, but I don't want to have to. I didn't lose it, did I? I do have a tendency to lose things. I had made it, so, okay. That's irritating. Sand. Is that all I have left for sand? That'll be more than enough anyway. I'm gonna get that running real quick. Because you can get it through the sag mill, I believe. Go. Put that in the... Is that right? Yes, silicon. I'm gonna need a couple of those normal, so... I'm gonna stop that for a second. I just set that to redstone mode so it would keep going. Because I need some for the printed circuits and some for the machine. So I don't want to mess that up. Where am I? There we go. So, for the grid, we needed 3 silicon, a diamond, and 4 rich quartz. So I should have everything here. Let's see if we can just do it. There we go. So we have our controller. Next thing we're gonna need. It's the grid, and then you upgrade that, I think. So a normal grid, yeah, this is where we get into this. So basic processor, printed silicon. Oh yeah, we need to make the solderer first. That was the way it works. Solderer. So 3 enriched and sticky pistons. Not a problem. So iron, 4 stone. So 8 stone, 8 cobble. Make sure. 8 cobble, 6 wood. I'm gonna bring a stack of redstone because I saw it there. And iron. Did I bring iron? No. Here we go. And I'm gonna need some slime balls, so over here somewhere. Should be able to use these ones, so we'll just use those ones. Butter, boom, here, boom. Oh, pistons first. Boom. We make 2 of those. And then, oh, sticky pistons first. 2 of those. Then the solder. Okay, so that's taken care of. So let's go find a spot for these. I'm actually just going to stick. I'm probably going to move this whole setup really soon. I just want to get everything up, running, and working. And, you know, proof of concept and all that jazz. Make sure everything's working properly. So that's fine. That's fine. That has power. It sees the solder. So that's exactly what we want. So the next step. I was working on the grid. The reason you make the solder is what gets you pretty much the rest of the system. It's the thing that makes you all your processors, and you're going to need it a lot. So get to it. I'm going to need a bunch of these. I'm just checking if I need any silicon. Normal silicon anywhere else. And it doesn't look like it. I did see quartz, so I'm going to grab some of that. And I am going to have to smelt a few things, but I'll do it over here. I'm going to let this run again and make the printed circuits. There you go. F3. We'll use that. We'll get those started. I need 4, I think, for the first machine, so I might as well grab it. Hurry up. You slow poke. There we go. 6. That'll get us started. Now, I'm going to need a ton of limit time anyway, so if I make extras, that is not a big deal. Let's see here. Grid. Let's start with the destruction core. So that's a basic processor, which is a printed silicon and a basic processor. So we're going to have to smelt an iron. I'm going to see the things I got to smelt first. So I need to smelt an iron. Gold. Gold. Oh, those are the same. 2 golds, an iron, and a glowstone. So I need 1 glowstone. 1 glowstone. Where am I keeping my glowstone? I hope I didn't use it all. Okay. Because I did make a bunch of those lamps at one point. So we'll just run over here and get this stuff done. So it was 1 diamond. 2 gold. And a glowstone. Oh, it's just straight glowstone. You didn't need that. Okay. What was the other one that's stuck in there then? No, everything else is fine. Okay. So I should have this in here, this in here. Don't care about that. I should have 2 of those, shouldn't I? Yes. Okay. So, back to this. So, let's go back to the grid. I'm going to go with the gold ones first, I guess. So, printed silicon, redstone, and a printed improved processor. So, go with 2 glowstone, or printed improved processor, and 2 redstone, I mean. That should make those. I'm going to run downstairs because I'm pretty sure I'm going to need 2 more printed silicon. If I don't, oh well. Here. That's done. Okay. And this is almost done. So that's beauty. So there's 1. 2. And what was the next one? Let's go with the diamond one. So first, basic processor. So we need a redstone and a basic processor. Oh, I need to smelt an iron. Well, there you go. Smelt an iron. then work on the other one. Melt an iron. There you go. There you go. I got the two of these. Look at the destruction core. So we're gonna need apprentice silicon. Is that another iron? Oh, you buggers. I should have checked this all. Yeah, one more iron. So what I'm doing right now is this laps back and forth because, like I said, this is a pretty new mod to me. I haven't used it. It's a lot like, Applied Energistics, but it's still different and quirky in its own ways. Quite a bit different, actually. So yeah, still learning the kinks. It actually seems simpler in the end. Much simpler, I would have to say, than Applied Energistics. So I can make either of these now. So redstone, printed silicon. Redstone, printed silicon. Helps if I get the redstone in there. Go. And what was the other one? The other one needed redstone as well. So, oh, I guess I need two of these. So, do this. That. Take our basic processor, and this one has to be mixed with diamond, was it? All right. No, completely wrong. I have no idea what I'm doing. There we go. Back here, here. So this one had to be mixed with glowstone. Mix that one with glowstone. There we go. That gives us this. Got two of those. And the last one had to be mixed with quartz. Let's do that. Did I not grab quartz? Of course I didn't. Why would I grab quartz? That just makes sense. We don't want to grab the things that we need. We don't want to take one of the most quartz intensive packs in the game and use quartz, or bring any quartz for that matter. Did I not need that? Must have not. That must be for something else. We'll see. Maybe I do need it. So for the grid, what's left? Grid. We got the housing. We got this. And we got that. So let's not run over there where we don't need to be. It's going to be so nice when this is done. It's going to be so nice. It's going to be, I'll be have all my items in one place, not all over the place. And just, I thought I made this. Did I already use it? I probably did. Oh, I would have used it for the other one. This is kind of like the chassis for the, oh, that's iron. For the Ender IO machines, you just use this in all of these machines, so. Although this one's much easier to make, I must say. So let's do this. Bam. So we got a grid. I'm going to upgrade that right away. Oh, that's what I need the diamond for. So we got this, this, and this. And a crafting station. So I'm going to need 4 wood. Here we go. Yep. Take that. I'm going to go over here and make that processor. And hopefully just silicon. Yes. There we go. And I guess I solder them all together. That's pretty cool. So I don't have to go back to the crafting grid. So this. This and that. I can put that right back. Put that here. Put that there. There you go. And the last thing we're going to need. Cables. Actually, we're gonna break this for a second. Boop. It's that simple. If you break this one and you have items in there, they're gonna fly all over the place. But this interface one, I just wanna put it somewhere else. There we go. Interface one, I'll probably put right here. This'll make the straightest path. For now. Basically, the interface is what I'm gonna use to join the cables. So. You have to remember where this block is, because right now this is the only block a cable can connect to. So that's a thing. So we got a grid. I'm gonna move that solder. That's gonna bother me. I want the grid on top of this and the solder for now. I'm gonna end up with a bunch of those anyway. Cable, not a cable-y, cable. The cables for this are these ones. Need quite clear glass, or is it any glass? Any block glass. More enriched, so I just need two glass, and I am done, it's that simple. Okay, this is actually really easy. Here, that'll give us 12, we don't need that many. Oh, we need one more thing. To make it read the chest as a storage block, we need one of these. And that's a whole new step. Okay, well then. Let's look at this right this time. We're gonna need a quartz. We're gonna need three of these printer processors, I think. So let's make sure. Yes, so we're gonna need to smelt three iron. And a gold, I think. Nope, where's it? Two iron and gold. There's one iron. That one's just a one step one, right? Yes. But two iron and gold. Let's get those done right away. Smelt two iron and gold. And I can go hook up the cables while that's going. So, long chest. There's gold. And iron. Tell me I have iron. Iron. Here we go. The wire's hooked up. I don't know if the storage counts as a wire or not, so we'll wait. Did I need anything else for that? Just two chests. Chests aren't a problem. I get them from my mob farm whenever I want them. And after this, I'm not going to really need them. I'll have some of those chests around in random places, but for the most part, not really going to need chests. They all done? Yes, they are. Excellent. So, which one's first? So this one. Oh, that one is redstone and processor and a silicon. I think this one is too, right? So let's make two of those. Ooh, the grid. That's the grid. Look at that. I'm going to turn that to a crafting grid, but that's a thing. Boom, boom, boom. Those done. I can't think of anything else I need to get done, but I can set up this recipe while I'm waiting. Two chest, cable, and what's the rest? Oh, three quartz enriched. I see there's some broken textures. I love it. There we go. That last processor. That's those. And what's the other one? Just get it cooking. Silicon, redstone, and that. Okay. This, I guess, is the only really two-stage one. There we go. And the other ones, I got to combine one with quartz and one with glow dust. And I doubt I brought more glow dust. I didn't. Okay. I'm so excited for this. This is gonna be amazing. This is the shizzle right here, I tell ya. Oh, the quality of life change. It's gonna be amazing. But this is literally the last piece we need, and this is effectively set up. I can't do auto crafting or none of that jazz, but I can use this as a giant storage system, and that in itself is amazing. And a crafting station. So I can, anything I have, just pull it up, hit the plus sign thing. I can either craft it or I can't if I don't have the stuff. But I immediately, if I do have it, I can just, oh yeah, quartz. Quartz. Yep. If I have it, it's just that simple. It's going to be such a big deal. There we go. And this. And I think I need to break that. Boop. And. Oh, that was already in there. Why did I break that? For fun? I broke that for fun. So if you want to have some fun, come here and break your crafting grid. Because it's fun. I was thinking I still had to upgrade it, but I already did that, so. Okay, so here, 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 here. And we'll come over here, and we'll see if this, it looks like it has a wire attached, so. Boom, yes it does. And I don't need to do anything there. I just came here to show you. This thing, this chest can hold 1,778,112 items. Let me repeat that. This thing can hold 1,778,112 items. Look at that. Beautiful. And this isn't like the old applied to energistics where it worked in stacks. So if you had one item, it counted as a stack. So it ate up 64, ate one of your slots of 64 items, even if you only had one. Same as any item that wasn't stackable. So it ate up tons of space. And this, if it says it holds 1,778,000, whatever the rest of it was, items, that's what it holds. And yeah, it's up and running. We're cooking with gas now. Like, look at this. Look at that. Just get it all in there. Get in there. Go. I can't wait. Can't wait. Oh, I need some food. I put my food in there by mistake. Give me my tasty toast. There we go. So yeah, I can do this now. So using this, like this thing has this storage system, refined storage, has its own storage. I mean, same as applied energetics. So you can use the drives. Where is it? There's drives. The drives. And then you gotta make drives. Then you gotta make, like, not these fluid storage ones, these item storage. So you gotta make this, you gotta make that. This is just for the, this is a 1K one. So you gotta make this just so you can make the first level 1K storage disk. You know what I mean? Where all I did, and that still only holds, I think, like 1,000 items. This holds 1,778,000. I like saying that. 1,778,112. And I already have 2,700 items in there. It's 0% full. Oh, I love it. It's so good. It's so good. I hate that I've learned to rely on these things. But at the same time, it's just so nice to have all your items in one central place. You're not looking through chest all the time. And you can do all your crafting right here. It just pulls the items from this, and you don't have to worry about it. I want it to JEI circonized. That's what I want. Yes. So if I go to, say, grid. Yes, it goes through the search bar as well. I always set it to JEI circonized. Sorting, if you have nothing in here, you can set it to sorting name, quantity. I guess that's the two options. Sorting descending or ascending, of course. Display normal, no craftables, only craftables. We'll keep it on normal, and we don't care about a redstone signal. There is a way to set this up, so you can set it to a pressure plate if you have real low power early on. So, maybe it's here. It's one of those. I think it is. You can just put it there and set it to redstone signal, and what are those called? The trap plate things. What are they called? Pressure plates. And yeah, you can do it that way. Oh, I'm gonna leave those here. Oh yeah, we need all our dust in there. And yeah, then you can just have it powered at that time. It doesn't eat that much power, really. I could check the power usage. It's actually not that much. And yeah, this is it. This is it. Like right now, it's draining like zero RF a tick right now. 2,000. It's using 8RS, which is like a refined storage power system. But it's automatically converted in the RF, so you don't have to worry about yet another system of power. Give me back my food. There we go. Anyway, I think that's it. I think I might end this video here. I mean, there isn't much else to see. I have a fully functioning, ridiculous storage system. Like, look at this thing. Look at it. Just look at it. It's a giant gold chest. I mean, what else can you ask for? I mean... And once again, I'm just going to say it just because it'll probably annoy people, but I like saying it. This thing is holding 5,599 items. Its full capacity is 1,778,112. It is 0% full. This thing is ridiculous. This thing is insane. Oh, I love it. Yeah, so next video, what was I going to get into? There was something I was going to get into right away, and I'm trying to remember. Let me think. I'm going to think. I'm going to do thinking? I'm not going to tell you, because I honestly don't remember. I might start Britannia, but I think there was something else going to start first. We'll just talk about it in the next video. You'll be able to read the probably the name of the next video and be able to figure it out real quick. I don't know why I always tell you guys. I just like letting you know which way I'm headed. I'm still going to get into Britannia soon. I'm going to get into Mystical Agriculture really soon. And Roots. I really want to do Roots, but like I said, I had to start Britannia first. Because you actually need the regular Minecraft flowers. And if I go to grass over right now and start just bone mealing it, the only flowers I'm going to get are the red and yellow ones. Which I need for Britannia. But to be able to convert them into the other ones you need for Roots, you need Britannia. So, that's a thing. Anyway, there's tons of things in Britannia and both Roots that I want anyway. But I think that's that. We're going to end this video. This was a great one. I really enjoyed this. Other than derping and thinking I needed more gold and wasting resources, I think I wasted about 100 gold. But it's just gold. We can make more. Not a problem. I made like 200 and... In 5 minutes, so not a problem with my sieving system. So and they're not even enchanted yet. I might at the start of next video I'm going to let me see how many diamonds I have. Do I even need diamonds? I don't need diamonds. It's levels. I'm gonna start enchanting the sieves with I'm gonna do all looting first. I'm not gonna worry about efficiency. I'm going to get all the looting on it, on them that I can. I should be able to do 5 or 6 of them, because I think that thing has about 80 levels, 60 to 80 levels on it now. Which means, it doesn't actually mean 80 levels. If I'm at level 0 and I take 10 levels, it like drops like 1 level of it. So, it's same as your character. As you get higher level, it takes more levels. But, yeah, there's an immense amount of experience in there either way. I should be able to do 5 or 6 of them, and I'm just going to show you the insane amount of drops I'm going to get from that. Anyway, that's it. I'm going to end this video right here. I'm going to ramble on because I am pumped. I'm going to move all this stuff, and I'm going to break all that crap, and yeah, I'm going to free up space. I'm going to empty all my chests into this system, and yeah, well, let's take that. I need a tool and this. Oh, and my bag. I need my bag. Not that you guys care. Anyway, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like. If you really enjoyed it, please hit that subscribe button and you'll get more videos. I'm going to only get better at these videos as time goes on. I know I'm pretty fresh, but I have a lot of knowledge. I know what I'm doing. I've played a lot of modded. There's a lot of stuff that I'm going to show you in the future that I'm skipping now, because I know a lot of people who've played modded for years, they might not find my videos the, you know, most informative, because they're looking at some of the stuff. Well, a lot of them didn't know this, and they didn't know some of the other stuff I showed too, for sure. But they would know a lot of stuff. They'd know how to build the smeltery and all that jazz. But for the regular player, a lot of you have no clue, like how to easily compress cobble, for instance, or how to set up auto obsidian or auto soul sand or auto, you know what I mean? They have no idea. They don't know how to set up a nice little smeltery chain. Well, vanilla guys might know that. But yeah, anyway, that's why I'm doing this. I'm showing things in a different way. And I'm enjoying it. I'm loving this. Like, I like playing through new mods, and this was a new mod, and this mod's cool, and this is a new mod to me. But I'm gonna try to save this for later in the game, doing the rest of this, all the auto crafting, because I find it breaks the game. Like, you get to the point where you're doing auto crafting, and it just does everything for you. It does everything for you, and you don't actually enjoy any of the mods because this does all the work for you. Refined storage or applied energistics, it doesn't matter which one. So I'm going to leave it as storage and as a crafting system. That is it for now. But yeah, I'm gonna end it here. Like, again, I'm just rambling. So I'm gonna end it here. And if you liked, leave a like. If you really liked, subscribe. Please do. And leave a comment. Tell me what I'm doing right or wrong. Or give me tips and tricks. I love them. I love them. I love things like this. Yeah. Have a good one. Just everyone have a good one. And I'm going to go now. I'm just going to leave. I'm going to stop talking in 2 seconds and just go away. Bye.